Today, we're going to cover a lot, but I want to start by talking about something that humans just need. We lust for it, crave it even, and we'll do it anywhere, the bed, the sofa, the car, hell, even on the beach. It's something that we can easily take for granted, and yet getting enough of it can lead to a healthier, happier lifestyle. It's sleep. Today, we're going to talk about sleep tracking on the Galaxy Watch 4 Classic. I've done many little tests of the Galaxy Watch 4 accuracy over the last year since its initial release, and what I really want to do now is bring a better quality, slightly more thorough test to the table and really hone in on those sleep tracking functions, because a lot of reviewers do tend to miss that out. Now, I have discovered something pretty horrifying, if I'm honest, and reluctantly, I will share it with you towards the end of the video, so stay tuned for that. But now, let's take a look at the Galaxy Watch 4 Classic and the O2 Ring from Wellue. So before I show you the test results, let's take a closer look at the Galaxy Watch 4 sleep functions and take a look at the O2 Ring, which is a medical-grade device used for measuring O2 levels. So let's begin with the O2 Ring. You might not be as familiar with this one, but the blood oxygen sensor in this is medically certified, so this will very much be our baseline for the testing. And what it also does is vibrates to turn you over if you start snoring, for example. Now, there's a couple of key differences which make the O2 Ring better all round for these sorts of tests. First being, it uses transmissive measuring, whilst most smartwatches measure by reflection. The sort of measuring the O2 Ring uses is what's used by doctors and in hospitals, so it's very reliable and very accurate, and again, medically certified. That's not the only reason it's more accurate as well. It also records data every 4 seconds, which will give you a more accurate histogram of what's going on while you're asleep. And lastly, it can also store up to 10 hours of continuous measurement data, and all of that data gets put into the app, which will allow you to export it and take it to your doctor if needs be. So the Galaxy Watch says it will give you sleep insights by measuring your blood oxygen and snoring. It does this actually by using your phone as well. So the idea is you have your phone nearby when you're wearing your watch to bed, and your phone will record any moments it thinks you are snoring. That, along with the blood oxygen monitoring from your watch, will give you some really great insights into what's going on when you're asleep, and it'll tell you for how long you've been in a deep sleep, a light sleep, REM sleep, or even awake. So again, before I share my results, let's do a quick accuracy test comparing the Galaxy Watch 4 to the O2 Ring, just to see how accurate the Galaxy Watch actually is in that department. So I'll be really quick with this. As you can see, first test is pretty much bang on. Let's go again. Yep. Also within one unit, which I think is a really good margin for error. I think you can safely say that the Galaxy Watch is accurate enough in this case, but we'll get some better insights into how accurate it is overnight when we compare it to the O2 Ring across maybe 6 to 8 hours or so of sleeping. Okay, so it's the next morning, and coincidentally, I've had the worst night's sleep that I've had in weeks, possibly even months. It was just such an awful night, but a good one for testing nonetheless. So it's about 8:30 a.m. Usually I'm up at about 6, but because I had such a bad night's sleep, I just lay in. So let's see what the Galaxy Watch has been telling me and what the O2 Ring has been telling me. Apparently, I did 169 bicep curls at 11:40 p.m. Okay, so it's saying that I got 6 hours and 59 minutes of sleep, which isn't true. I don't think that I got anywhere near that. I think I was actually awake from around 10 o'clock all the way up until 2 o'clock, just trying to get to sleep. It has put a gap where I got up and got some water and stuff, but yeah, I'm not quite sure if it's quite got the time I was actually sleeping for right. Maybe it's gone off when I put my phone down to rest. Maybe that's what it's using there. So what else will it tell me? So actually, it's quite interesting. It tells me that I burnt 491 calories in my sleep last night, 54 minutes awake apparently, 57 minutes REM sleep, and then 4 hours and 15 minutes in a light sleep. And then it's saying I got 53 minutes of deep sleep. Again, I am seriously sort of doubting this. I really don't think I got that much sleep at all. The other thing that's interesting is that it's saying that my blood oxygen was under 90% for 1 minute and 44 seconds. Never had my blood oxygen go that low to my knowledge. And it's also saying that I was snoring for 18 minutes. Obviously, I wouldn't know, but I think the best thing to do now is to sort of cross-reference this with what the O2 Ring was saying and see if we can sort of work out what's going on here. Okay, so obviously this device works a little bit differently. This is also going off from when I put the O2 Ring on. In terms of O2 drops, it isn't saying that my O2 levels dropped below 90%. In fact, it's saying that they were the lowest SpO2 rating was 93%. And if I go into the other session, it's also saying, again here, it's saying the lowest SpO2 was 94%. So this isn't telling me that my O2 levels dropped below that 90% that the Galaxy Watch is saying. So since it was only for a minute or so, perhaps that was some sort of error, or just maybe I was like lying funny on my Galaxy Watch. I don't know. So yeah, I think what we're gonna do is just get on with my day again, and then we're gonna check back tomorrow, and hopefully I would have had a better night's sleep. Oh, it is actually a couple of days down the line. I didn't want to keep coming back every day because it would make the video so long and it's a lot of the same thing, but I feel like I've had a couple of nights of better sleep. So we're going to take a look at Samsung Health and see what it's actually telling us about my sleep patterns. So the most recent night I've had, it's saying that I got 6 hours and 24 minutes of sleep, which isn't actually that long. I'm pretty sure you're meant to get at least 8 hours. I never seem to be hitting that 8 hours mark, which is a little bit worrying. Now, something that I didn't notice earlier was actual sleep time. So it says that I was actually asleep for 6 hours and 4 minutes. So yeah, quite well under the 8 hours you're meant to be getting. And then it also says I burnt 450 calories. What's interesting about this, although I got less sleep, I actually felt a lot more refreshed after this. And I think that is because I had a lot more deep sleep. So it's saying here that I got 1 hour and 22 minutes of deep sleep, as opposed to well under an hour the other day. I think I only had 11% of my sleep as deep sleep. It also says that my blood oxygen was under 90% for over 2 minutes now. I don't think that's particularly a problem. And then also says for 11 minutes, I was snoring. So if we go back to the day prior to that, I got a bit more sleep. So it says I got 7 hours and 5 minutes. Actual sleep time was 6 hours and 39 minutes, calories burnt just under 500. But the interesting thing about this is that I only had 39 minutes of deep sleep, which is really, really interesting. But this day was when I discovered something absolutely horrifying, and I will show you later on in the video, but it's so bad that I actually think I'm gonna have to go to the doctors about it. It's just awful. But also on this day, it says my blood oxygen was only under 90% for 9 seconds, so improvement on that front compared to other days. So I'd say that I've learned quite a lot over the past few days, but I did mention at the start I learned something pretty horrifying about myself that I've been a bit reluctant to share with you, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Listen to this. No, that wasn't a gun going off. That was actually me. I wasn't even aware that I snored, let alone aware that I was actually a semi-automatic rifle. I mean, wow, that is just horrendous. It's actually kind of embarrassing as well. So yeah, although I didn't want to hear that ever, the Galaxy Watch 4 alongside Samsung Health is pretty damn good at giving you some really solid insights into what's going on when you're asleep. All jokes aside, I actually genuinely like that it records moments like that, because I genuinely would never have known. And although you're making a really loud, annoying noise, what's actually happening when you're snoring, your body is not getting enough oxygen, which can lead to some pretty serious health issues. So yeah, I think I'm gonna do something about that and maybe take this data to my doctor and see if I can work something out. Now, the cons: the blood oxygen monitoring, as we already saw, wasn't quite as accurate as we could have hoped for. Now, I don't think everyone is gonna be wearing an O2 ring and a Galaxy Watch 4. I think what you need to do is wear your Galaxy Watch 4 if you already own one, see how your sleep is going, and if you are seeing problems, maybe then invest in an O2 ring to get those accurate results so you can export that data and send it to your doctor. So the Watch 4 is fantastic. I'm really impressed with it. There is so much to explore with it, but the Galaxy Watch 5 Pro is just around the corner. So if you want to find out all the latest news on the Galaxy Watch 5 Pro, click the link in the top right corner now. For now though, I've been Alex. This has been Take It Easy. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.